I'm going to show you how to create and use normal distributions in Desmos graphing calculator. So the most simple way that we can do this is just typing normal dist and then a mean and standard deviation. So if I wanted to do the standard normal distribution, I would do 0 and 1. You can also find this function in, if you open the keyboard, click functions, go to distributions. We're going to use normal dist here. We're also going to use the CDF and inverse CDF functions as part of this demonstration. Once you create it, I recommend clicking Zoom Fit. Then you can see the distribution. You can see it out to 4 standard deviations on either side. When you're looking at this, the Y value really does not matter too much. If you want to remove that axis, you can. You can also even remove these grid lines. We really don't need them. All we're looking at is just the positions on the x-axis. So I like to look at it this way. If you want to start shading it and calculating probabilities, click Cumulative Probability. You can put in a left side, a right side, or both. For example, z-score from -1 to 1, 68%, -2 to 2, 95%, and -3 to 3 is 99.7%. Another example is to the left of 2.15. I would put in a max of 2.15. You'll see it shades all the way to negative infinity. Or I could do a right side, for example, 3.12. Now here's a nice thing about Desmos that you can't do in Staplet is you can put in really large numbers here. So I'm looking at 5 standard deviations to the right of the mean. I'm really shading, starting at that 5. You can see if I zoom way in, I can see where that starts to shade. In this view, we see it's tiny. It's gonna be in scientific notation. So that's a decimal point, 6 zeros, and then 286, essentially moving the decimal to the left 7 spaces there. Now, if I want to use this value, I will need to label this, for example, n equals, and then use that n.cdf function. Now, if I put 1 value, it's going to find the cumulative area to the left. So let me test this out. Let me put in a maximum value here of 2.15, and then here I'm shading to the left of 2.15, and it matches. If I want to go to the right of 2.15 is about 1.6%, I would just need to take the complement of that CDF function. So instead of shading to the left, it's subtracting it from 1, flipping it around to the right side. So that's just a little trick using the fact that there is a total area of 1 and finding the complement. If you want to find the probability between 2 points and output that, just put in 2 numbers like I did before. -1 to 1 is 68%. And just the nice thing about this is now this is a value. You can call this A and you can use that later for calculations. So that's something that you really get out of Desmos that you can't do with Staplet. So that was a standard normal distribution with a mean of 0 and a standard deviation of 1. Let's say I'm looking at a normal distribution with a mean of 64.5. and a standard deviation of 2.5. Resume. I don't want to look at this anymore. There's my full distribution. So one thing that doesn't work so great with this is the way the axis is numbered. It's not going to go by your standard deviations the way we would really like it to. You can change this step size if you want. I'm not sure that it's always going to work great for you. Here, I changed it to 2.5. The problem is I don't have my mean of 64.5 right in the middle. So that is a problem. It's not really always going to work for you. That's the downside to Desmos. I don't like the way it labels those axes as much, or at least being able to customize it. So doing some of the same things I did before, for example, finding the probability of, and this is women's heights in the United States, between 60 and 70 inches, I've got 95% right there. I can continue to use that n.cdf. Let's go 60 to 70 as well. Same amount there. Now I have an outputted value I can use. Other examples would be someone with the height below 67 inches. That's 84.13% of the time. And now using that CDF just with a left side probability, I just put in the one number as my input. So 67, that's going to find the left side probability. Using the complement to find the right side probability is the same as switching that. And then the other use for all of this is using the inverse CDF. So I'm actually going to go back to a standard deviation, a mean of 0 and a standard deviation of 1. And I'm going to use the inverse CDF. So n dot inverse CDF, and it kind of gets a little weird, but then if you just keep typing, it straightens out. Like I said, that's also available in the distribution functions there. So now what I'm doing is I'm typing in a probability. Let me go to just the area to the left of a z-score of 2, so we can see what that looks like. That's 97.7%. This inverse CDF is going to take an inputted area and turn it into a z-score, or if I have a mean and standard deviation other than 0 and 1, a data value x. So I just went in a circle. I plugged in a 2. I said, what's the area to the left of that? It's 97.7%. Here I said, what is the z-score that has an area of 97.7 to the left? Approximately 2. And so that's how the inverse CDF works. It's a little trickier if you have, for example, a right side area. The area to the right of 3 is 0.0013. I would have to do 1 minus 0.0013 when I input that to be able to get back to something that's close to that 3, and there's a lot of rounding going on, so it doesn't work as well. So there are limitations to that inverse in Desmos, but you can do anything you want to do. The last thing that I might want to do here is find the inverse with an applied problem, a non-standardized distribution. Going back to that mean of 64.5, standard deviation at 2.5. Let's say, for example, 67 inches. I want to take that area and turn it back to an x value. I just plug in my area, 0.8413, and I'm at about 67 inches there, a little bit of rounding error. Or I could just look up some unknown, like the 90th percentile would be 67.7 inches, and then I can check that here. That's about the 90th percentile there. So that's how you'd use it in Desmos for more precision and to be able to use those outputs to do further calculations.